عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه. Brothers and sisters, one thing that I encourage myself and I remind myself first and foremost, the new brothers and sisters, is to be real with yourselves and to be real and genuine and honest and truthful with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is one of the keys to sincerity, and we all know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said that indeed actions are according to their intentions, and for each person he will have that which he intended. Now, many of us we take on personas and we display characteristics which are not necessarily ourselves, and we are not truly reflecting what is within our hearts. Now, what I don't mean by this is that you try to be pious and you try to be righteous, but then you fall short. And we all know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said that all of the children of Adam, they commit sins, and the best of those who commit sins are those who make tawbah. So I'm not referring to you sin in private, or you have deficiencies, or you have faults and you have weaknesses. But I'm referring to traits and people and characteristics from amongst ourselves where we actually take on another person and we live a lie and we try and be something or somebody that we are not. And many of us are guilty of this, wallahi, many of us are guilty of this. And so I want to remind myself and counsel myself and admonish myself and you brothers and sisters, and to say, look, just keep it real, be real with yourself. And if you're struggling with something, make dua, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and break down and let your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala guide you, but you have to turn back to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And be honest with yourself and speak to yourself, have a conversation with your own self and say, look, is this really me? Is this really me? Is this really how I am? I'm wanting to live my life? Is this really how I want to behave? Because we find people who they start practicing, and potentially due to the people who they hang around with, maybe the person who they are married to, maybe their crowd, maybe their family members, whatever it is, they become molded in a certain way and they take on a persona, Seeking acceptance, seeking the pleasure of a certain person or a group of people, but it never lasts. And after a certain amount of time, you find that their world comes tumbling down because they never did it for the sake of Allah, and they weren't sincere for the sake of Allah, seeking the pleasure of Allah. And so this is why we often find brothers who are practicing. They begin practicing and after a short amount of time, they shave their beards off, or you might marry a person and you are seeking that person's pleasure. You want to become practicing to seek the pleasure of the person, and you're not seeking the pleasure of Allah by that action. And as a result of that, what happens? When you break up or you have an argument, what is the first thing that is going to be affected? It is the acts of worship which you did, seeking the pleasure of the people, not seeking the pleasure of Allah. And this comes under ar-riya. This comes under riya, which is minor shirk. And you need to know that minor shirk is or riya is one of the most dangerous of things, because a person might struggle to do something for years and years and years, but he never straightened his intention, and so that action it was based upon showing off or seeking acceptance from somebody else. And as a result of that, the things that he believes that he is doing or she is doing that is going to earn him or her reward, in the end there's no reward. In fact, it's just punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and his efforts are going to be rejected. So a reminder to myself and then you brothers and sisters, keep it real, straighten your intention, ask yourself, the things that I'm doing, why am I doing them? Who do I want reward from? And yes, I'm going to fall short, but when I fall short and when the calamities come my way, what's going to happen? Am I going to rebel against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of the fact that the person who I loved, he no longer loves me, she no longer wants to be with me, and as a result of that, the changes that I made, which were for them, then suddenly all of those changes are going to be reversed. So this is a reminder, brothers and sisters, keep it real. Whenever you do anything, always make sure you're doing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't attach your religion, don't attach your obedience to Allah around the neck of a woman or around the neck of a man. Do it for Allah, seek the pleasure of Allah. If you do this, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, you will make lasting changes, and those changes will take root in your heart and they will become beloved to you. But if you do it for a person, then when that person is beloved to you, those changes will be beloved to you. But when you're angry at that person or you hate that person, those changes will no longer be beloved to you, and you'll begin to roll back on those changes, and suddenly you are no longer making progress, but rather you have regressed. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us sincere in everything that we do, and I ask Allah jalla wa ala to forgive our many major shortcomings, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us in our affairs. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.